They're a championship caliber team.
This has been the thought all along. They have enough to compete night in and night out, but they're not taking 4 out of 7 from a top team in this league. No way.
So the opening lineup for the Heat, Robinson on the wing. He's joined by Butler. Then it's Bam Adebayo. Then there's Terry Rozier. And it's Highsmith in at the 4 spot. And for the 76ers, they've got Tobias Harris. Hield is out there with Tyrese Maxey. Then it's Reed, and it's Batum in at the 3 spot. Both teams limping, Steve, into this game. It's going to be, we know, a war of attrition.
Kevin, they're trying to wear each other down. These are also the types of matchups where new stars can emerge. Some guys will be getting more minutes. Got to make the most of them.
Knocks down the 3 ball.
This is where Tobias has really improved, keeping his eyes up, making plays for others.
Passes to Adebayo. Rozier for 3. Drills it from outside.
Matching baskets from the perimeter, an earmark of today's game.
Hey, players love competition, and the fans love it as well.
The pass to Reed. Hield attacking. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
Shot's good.
Impressive display of focus there from Hill. Never lost sight of the rim.
And he'll be shooting his first free throw of the game here.
One shot.
Year in and year out, Smitty, the Heat bring energy and commitment to the defensive end.
Kevin, the Miami Heat has a strong culture, and they've done a good job bringing in players that match their identity. It's led to a great deal of success.
Now, here is Robinson, coming off a stellar performance against Detroit. 6 on the shot clock. Batum against Butler. Yep, it counts.
He usually lives in the paint, but you can't give him the mid-range. He'll knock it down.
Maxey against Rozier. For 3, Harris. It's hauled in by Bam Adebayo. It's stolen by Hield. Pass to Maxey. Reed with it. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. 4 on the shot clock. It's up a 3. It's good. Nice touch there from Maxey.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Now, here's Rozier. He's given them a healthy dose of offense each and every night with an average of 20 points a game. Butler scored the basket, his 2nd of 2 attempts.
This is where you get Butler the rock because he is so good at finishing.
Philadelphia's gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Pass to Reed. Back to Maxey. And he uses the glass on the layup. Maxey's got 5 points so far.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
And in this first quarter, about 3 minutes played. Now Rozier passes it to Butler. Tyrese Maxey grabs the miss. He feeds it to Reed. Over Butler. Out of bounds. Miami takes possession. Now a chance to take a look at some numbers for Tobias Harris.
And guys, for a measure of how he's performing offensively, Look no further than the true shooting percentage. There's been a steady drop in his last five games, and he's got to be scrambling now to get that feel back.
Catching up on the changes for Philadelphia. Mohamed Bamba, he's checked in for Harris. And it's Kyle Lowry in for Nicholas Batum. Now the pass to Adebayo. Bamba with the block.
The main thing you get with Bamba, imposing defender, shot blocker, alters everything in the paint.
Ooh.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
Ah, they're going for the throat. And 101 left to play in the first. Here's Rozier. His last outing, he had 18 points. Outside for Robinson. Here's the three. It's hauled in by the 76ers. They defeated Charlotte in their last game.
Yeah, I think they prepared to face more defensive pressure in that one. Didn't happen, and boy, they just rolled.
They came in focused and ready to play, and despite facing little resistance, they never pulled back.
...29 seconds left in the first. Rozier kicks to Adebayo. Adebayo with a screen on heel. Pass to Highsmith. And here's Adebayo.
Bamba with the block.
And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. Let's take a second look at that fantastic block.
And right out of the gate, trying to set the tone defensively, you gotta love that energy.
We've got 13 seconds left in the first quarter. And here is Butler. Misses and the dry spell continues.
Out of character for him to miss that shot. Maybe just a little too casual there.
And so it's Philadelphia in the driver's seat. Up 8 points at the end of the quarter. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. And we'll be right back after this. And it's good to have you back with us as we celebrate St. Patrick's Day with more NBA action on 2K Sports. What stands out to you guys from the 76ers in this one?
Throughout the first quarter, they did a great job of just running the offense.
Credit the game plan coming in. They've identified the right matchups, and the execution is there.
Here's Butler. 14 points from him the last game against Detroit. On the court for Miami here in the second. Wright is out there with Jimmy Butler. Then there's Caleb Martin. And it's Hawkes in at the small forward. Here's Jovic. Pass to Hawkes. Down to 5 on the shot clock. 3-pointer, Butler. Great D that time from Oubre.
Yeah, but the defense was determined not to give him an inch of free space.
And for Jimmy Butler, he's the type of player we know, Steve, that fills in the gaps wherever his team needs him.
Kevin, he's often the top scorer, defender, and playmaker for his team. His desire to win is unmatched.
Jimmy Butler might be the most overlooked superstar in this league.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
They're unselfish. They're one passing shot. The ball well, setting up teammates, playing team basketball, and their focus.
You also have to admire how they've challenged the defense inside, getting a lot of points in the paint.
And the free throw, no good. And we see players sometimes, Greg, after a change of venue, they change teams, suddenly taking the next step. What can key that leap?
Kevin, it's not all just opportunity and fit. I think there can be a mental component as well. A fresh start can give you a blank canvas to try new things.
And now we've got some time to check in from the sidelines. What do you got for us, D.A.?
Thank you, Kevin. Jimmy Butler made some headlines a while back when he said he wished the NBA would allow more of the scrapping we saw in decades past. So would I. He says that would suit his game, though. Jimmy said, I want to run into people and see who falls down first, who's going to quit first. That's the style of basketball I like to play. Kevin?
Yep, you're right. And it shows, D.A., it shows. Thank you so much. Out of bounds, Philadelphia takes possession. Nicholas Batum, he's checked in for Martin. Robinson's checked in for the Heat. Terry Rozier comes in for Wright. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Lowry deciding where to go with it here. Bamba with it to the paint. And Harris gets it to go on the assist by Bamba. Harris has got the lead up to 10 now for the 76ers. Here's Rozier. Passes it to Martin. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
The Heat shooting their first free throw this game.
You've got to appreciate their ability to make free throws, 81% as a team.
Here's what Philadelphia's going with right now. Heald comes in for Bamba. And Maxey subbed in for Kelly Oubre. Heat also with a sub. Highsmith is checked in. Free throw, no good for Martin.
Known as a floor spacer due to his shooting, Caleb Martin knows his role and plays it well.
Here's Heald. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Heald's got 8 points.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
And, Greg, while the Sixers have been a fact, time and again, they've been unable to get past the conference semifinal.
Where they've bowed out in 5 of the last 6 years, but you go back, they haven't made it any further since Allen Iverson led them to the finals back in 01.
And the 76ers making a change here. Reed's checked in. Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Now, here's Rozier. Three on the clock. And the pass to Highsmith. Count that bucket.
Yeah, they've gotten into a nice flow this quarter.
And so it's Maxey with it. He brings it up for Philadelphia. Home court didn't seem to help any last time they met. We'll see if it makes a difference this time.
Yeah, they dropped the last game of this matchup. Their bench wasn't able to keep up with the opposing reserves offensively.
A shot by Batum, no good. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Adebayo down low. Read on him. The shot by Adebayo, no good. Philadelphia leading by 8. Inside. Outside for Batum. Harris outside. Pass to Maxey. The tray. It's hauled in by Bam Adebayo. Here's Hawkins, guarded by Harris. Here's Jaquez. No scoring in this one. And the shot goes in.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
The 76ers have gone 3-of-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. Heald sets the pick for Maxey. The dish to Reed. And it's blocked! And he keeps control of the ball. Jaquez the pass to Highsmith. Up and in on the layup. Now just a 4-point 76ers lead.
And really, it's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Outside, Maxey. Harris, right side. Happy to see that one go in for his second make in 5 attempts.
Even against good defense, Harris uses a combination of strength and agility to either overpower or elude the defender.
Now Rozier fires for three. A three-pointer is right on target. Rozier's got 6 points.
Talented, driven. He puts constant pressure.
Oh, he made it!
He got it to go, and he beat the buzzer.
Wow. That's a miracle. Are you kidding me?
I didn't think that shot had any chance of going in. Just shows you that anything can happen in this game.
And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their shooting has been the big key. Their percentage from the field so far has been terrific. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
Much different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
Welcome in for halftime. And what's on tap, you ask? I can answer that. So far, it's been a nice outing for the Philadelphia 76ers.
You could tell they love playing in front of this crowd. The energy helps fuel this team right now. The sixth man is doing their job, Shaq.
Yeah, there's no let up in these fans, loyal and loud.
And let's take a glance at what lies ahead, a look at the upcoming schedule.
And you know, for that matchup with the Suns, you look at both teams collectively, it seems like a toss-up. It could come down to individual matchups.
Yeah, there is some serious star power in this one. Feels like somebody's going to step up and have a monster night. And that concludes halftime. Now time to send it over to Kevin Harlan as the game's about to resume.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. The Heat trail by 6. We've got Maxey. Reed out there with Tobias Harris. Then it's Heald. And it's Batum in at the 3, the small forward. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. Now here's Butler. Adebayo with a screen on Batum. Lock at 6. And Adebayo gets it to go on the assist by Butler. Adebayo's got his second bucket of the game to go. Philadelphia leading by four. And they're great at both ends, but the Sixers offense, Greg, the Sixers offense is elite.
And it all starts with Joel Embiid feasting inside and at the free throw line. And his teammates reap the benefits as well with wide open shots on the perimeter. Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
And it's Butler missing. And so it's Maxey who brings up the ball for the 76ers. It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aldridge. What's the latest, David?
Thanks, Kevin. The NBA, of course, is so loaded, it's not easy to come out on top. Joel Embiid said, for us to be able to win, we need to try to be perfect. I need to play at the highest level possible. Our shooters and defense have to do their job. It's tough, but it's fun. I guess you have to enjoy the journey as well, Kevin.
Yep, the journey, right, David, is the reward. That's for sure. Dave, thanks. The Heat trail by seven. And here is Rozier. He has six. Butler finds Rozier. Butler, a screen on Maxey. Rozier for three. Batum grabs the miss. Philadelphia has gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. It's deflected. Batum against Butler. Adebayo with a screen for Butler. Count it, and the 76ers' lead has been cut down to 5 on the bucket from Adebayo.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes play. Here's Maxey. They get the rebound. The Heat trail by 5. Here's Rozier. Some solid defense from Maxey.
He goes up strong, but he is met with resistance. I think that surprised him a little bit.
Harris kicks to Maxey. Back to Harris. Shot clock at 6. Banked in off the glass. Harris has got 6.
Nice bucket. The polished inside game. Something Harris relies on.
Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. And the first time out of the game called for the Heat.
And coaches looking to seize every advantage, maximize every possession.
Critical part of the game. You have to be flexible. You have to be able to adjust what you're doing.
Kelly Oubre is checked in for Philadelphia. Lowry comes in for Maxey.
And taking a look here at some stats for Robinson. How last month turned out for him, averaging 13 points per game, 3 assists and 3 rebounds. He's been making the right decisions and letting the game come to him. Solid play all around.
He's not trying to take over necessarily. He's just taking what the defense allows and contributing to the calls.
A minute 20 left in the third. Adebayo with a screen on Lowry. Rozier for three. Rebound by the 76ers. Harris has got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. The drive by Lowry over Rozier. Lowry can't get it to go. The Heat trail by 7. Rozier kicks to Adebayo. Adebayo with a screen on Harris. Outside, Martin. Pass to Adebayo. 6 to shoot. And it's blocked. To the inside. Here's Martin, and finished off by Martin.
Love watching these guys take flight. Caleb Martin is no exception.
There's 31 seconds left here in the third quarter. Oubre with it. Scoreless thus far. Lowry has the open look. His 3-pointer is off the mark. The Heat trail by 5.
Definitely got to use the clock here and get the last shot.
But you know, this is where your patience is tested. If you shoot too quickly, you give your opponent a chance to close out the quarter.
Rozier for 3 trains the 3-pointer. Rozier's got 9.
And over the course of his career, Rozier has really improved his 3-point numbers. That offseason work on the jumper has paid off big time.
3 quarters of play in a close game here. 76ers lead by 2. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. Let's listen in on what Eric Spoelstra had to say to his team.
Trust it. Good to great. Good to great. Don't settle for average shots. Move it.
Well, Coach Spo instructing his guys, Greg, to just take great shots.
I mean, no reason to rush into a bad shot, especially with 24 seconds to work with.
We've reached the 4th quarter, and what has been a very competitive game should be an exciting finish. On the floor for Miami, starting the 4th. Jimmy Butler is out there with Wright. Then it's Martin. And it's Jovic in at the center position. Now here is Martin. In the corner, Wright with it. Passes it to Jovic. Bamba with the block. And he gets it back. Block at 2. Stolen by Bamba. Now the pass to Martin. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So 1 free throw coming up. And a closer look here at the hustle stats for Philadelphia.
It's easy for me. Look at their defensive effort all game. The block total shows their commitment to contesting shots.
And they've really been able to get out in transition and produce. The defense hasn't had an answer for this up-tempo pace.
And that one falls for Martin. And it's Wright with the ball for Miami. They trail by 7. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Detroit, where they'll face the Pistons. That puts them squarely in the middle of this 5-game road trip. Martin against Martin. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Wright. A good-looking shot from the wing.
Oh, that's some fancy ball handling right there. Since when does he take guys off the dribble?
Payne dishes to Oubre. Now here's Payne, guarded by Wright. Outside Lowry. No good on the triple. The Heat trail by 5. Shakes him. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a 3-point play chance for him.
You know what, this is a skill set to be able to take the bump and stay on balance after the initial contact.
Timeout called, the Heat. The short rest, very important, and one of the benefits of this part of the game is getting on the same page with your team while having the chance to hydrate with Gatorade. Replenish your energy for the late game push. And the 76ers with a completely new group now. Right now, I'd send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Well, during that break, Eric Spoelstra had some words for his team. Now, with this game up for grabs, coach told his guys to think positive. He said, "We know this game is ours, fellas. We've earned it. I need you to show me right now that you want this. Can they get it done? We'll see, guys."
All right, David, thanks.
What's up?
Mentally and physically, Jimmy Butler is always ready to put up a fight and scrap for every bucket.
Maxey looking it over. Reed a screen on Rozier. Here's Maxey. He kicks it to Reed. And good that time. And the 76ers lead by 4.
If you came to watch a scoring battle, you're in the right place.
Yeah, both teams trying to close out strong. These are the fireworks that fans came to see.
Here's Butler. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Adebayo with a screen for Butler. Down low. And Adebayo throws it down.
A dangerous pick and roll partner. Adebayo's a high-level athlete with great size.
The 76ers have gone 3-of-4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Healed against Robinson. Outside, Maxey. Reed a screen from 13. And he recovers it. They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe.
And the second chance points aren't easy to come back. It's all about effort and hard work, and he has today made it look easy.
That's a carryover from the way he played in their last game. All-out energy plays on his way to a huge performance.
Throw good, Maxi.
And that tacks another big point onto the lead. Great and-one play showing us now a little bit of that killer instinct.
Adebayo with a screen for Butler. On the wing, Rozier. Adebayo with a screen for Rozier. A three-pointer, no good. Philadelphia leading by five. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Let's the three fly. Maxi, no good.
There was a mix-up defensively. Left him all alone. He just couldn't hit it.
Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Robinson's got his first 3 points of the game.
He has elevated to this position. Robinson knocking down big buckets in crucial moments.
One 11 left to play in the final quarter. Rozier against Maxi. Harris, good!
That was huge. You need a bucket? Who do you go to? A guy with a lot of skills and heart, Tobias Harris.
Now here's Butler. Adebayo with a screen on Batum. Releases from 15. Great D that time from Batum. A chance here to possibly put it out of reach.
This is when you really need to maintain your focus.
And they go to the intentional foul. The first, and that puts them up by five.
Slowly but surely, Harris continues to elevate his game. The shooting, the playmaking, the ability to make a difference.
So he gets them both, and it's a six-point ball game.
Job well done at the line on that possession. They'll make things a little easier on themselves if they can convert those.
Timeout called, the Heat. They're trailing by six. 34 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Guys, your thoughts?
An uphill climb. They need everything to break their way.
They also need to get the best shot you can as quickly as you can, and then immediately foul.
Robinson for three. Yes! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
Consistent from three-point land, Duncan Robinson with incredible range.
They'll be trying to take as much time off the clock as they can.
Exactly. Expect to see longer possessions from this point on.
Now a timeout called by Miami. They're trailing by six. 26 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Robinson for three, and it's Reed pulling it down, and now they decide to foul intentionally.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
And no good as the first free throw missing for him. We'll see if he can nail the second. And he does get the second one. And that makes it a 7-point lead.
Guys, let's just go ahead and call this one. It's over.
They couldn't make enough plays when it mattered. Interesting game, though, in terms of some of the matchups.
So the 76ers win it. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and for me, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it matters most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, David Aldridge, Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Tyrese Maxey.